is Jim Thirwell from Scraping Foetus Off the Wheel. You're listening to JJJ, and if you're gonna get down with Prey. Foetify, the experience, chewing things up and spitting them back out at the disgusting society that created this monster.
Radio, you know.
What's that?
You're talking to make radio programs, that kind of stuff, with leaving a gap at the end just for a track to come in and all that kind of stuff.
What do you think of radio as a medium? It's pretty mediocre, I'd say.
I used to listen to 3AK when it was a rock station. Was that 3AK? Was that...
Not being a Melbourne boy, I couldn't be sure.
I think they just appeal to wrinklies now.
Wrinklies? Are you worried about getting old?
Am I worried about it?
Yeah.
I've got better things to worry about than that.
What do you worry about?
Everything.
Except
getting old. I'm a big worrier. You know, I worry about worrying. You know, it worries me. Then did 2 years in art school, Melbourne State College, which gave me enough perspective to realise that that was exactly what I did not want to do, and I decided I wanted to make a clean slate of it and start afresh. So it seemed like a good idea to do so on the other side of the world, since I never chose to be born in Australia. It was tantamount
typical
to
middle class,
home, I guess. It was tantamount
typical
to
middle class,
home, I guess. It was tantamount to running away from home, I guess you'd say.
What kind of home was it? Was it a typical middle class home?
Fairly. Yeah.
And had you had any musical experiences while you were in Melbourne?
No.
All right.
None that I'd admit to. An overflow of ideas. I don't really have any desire to be there. I mean, I was there for 18 years. I mean, that's enough. Other cities deserve me. I don't feel the need to absorb Australian culture anymore. I think I got a decent dose of it then. An overflow of ideas, an overflow of ideas, an overflow of ideas, an overflow of ideas, an overflow of ideas. I didn't just go to London and start making records. I hadn't formulated the whole plan behind Self-Immolation or the Foetus family at that point. I knew that I wanted to do something involved with music, but I didn't know what it was. And I wanted to just immerse myself
in a totally different environment. So I just moved there, got a bed set, and held down a series of horrible jobs.
Then started to play music for my own benefit. Played in the band for about 10 months, and the band experience really brought to light for me that exactly what I had gone through in a whole band setup in terms of the democracy, rehearsing, having to either have one's ideas diluted or to accommodate someone else's mediocre ideas. These are all the things that, you know, exactly what I did not want to do, which was the big motivation in the first place to record a record by myself, playing everything. Not that I was a particularly accomplished musician, but I had an overflow of ideas and didn't want to see them tainted by other people, and I wanted to really keep that purity, and that was the big motivation in the first place. So in 1980 I just went into the studio one day and recorded and mixed my first single in a day called Spite Your Face by Foetus Under Glass, which came out on New Year's Day 1981.
Scraping Foetus off the wheel, is that basically Jim Thirlwell and there's no other involvement?
No, that's it. It's just me.
So you play everything that we hear?
Different group names that I use have different intentions behind them. Like the intention behind, say, Foetus Art Terrorism is different than Scraping Foetus off the Wheel in terms of both lyrics and musical formats. So I choose to give it a slightly different slant.
Could you describe then, say, how Fat sounds different to Scraping Foetus off the Wheel?
Well, the intention behind Foetus Art Terrorism is to use the genre of hip-hop or electro, or whatever you choose to call it, which is a genre of music dear to my heart, I like very much, but in terms of production and execution, I never think it's taken far enough. I mean, a lot of those records have one good idea, one good sound, but it's never taken far enough, and I wanted to marry it to a lot more relevant lyrics or stinging, or just basically feetify the experience.
taste for, but Calamity Crush goes at 111. Did you know that that was played in some dance clubs?
Oh, of course, it was a cult hit. Superseded by records that have come out since, because that has got some pretty wild things happening these days, which is great, and I'm glad.
Well, disco has always been put at sort of one end. That's a super commercial thing.
Well, I don't really see hip-hop as necessarily purely commercial, because, you know, I see it more as like it's an urban sound in terms of being an urban sound. It's almost like folk music, because it's very street music. You always hear kids walking by playing their own human beat boxes, you know, and so on. That's roots music, future roots music.
Then if we've got an idea what Foetus Art Terrorism is about, how then is that different from scraping Foetus off the wheel?
Well, Scraping Foetus off the Wheel is really the mainstay of my work, the most personal and focused pinprick example of my work. It's the most specific, it's my flesh volcano. Flesh volcano.
This There would have been another commandment. Thou shalt not slaver on thine cadaver when all thine fat is in the fire. This isn't the melody that lingers on. It's the malady that malingers on. There's the devil to pay. He can keep the change. I can't stand the thought of another cold day. Choose between suicide and genocide. I've been impaled by the sins of World War II. Can't sleep for the skins of 6 million Jews. I joined the Ku Klux Klan just to get the uniform. Complain. I found there was a hole in my spiritual parachute after I jumped from the astral plane. No escape from four stone slimy walls I built up while trying to knock them down. There's war and death, watch death, rattle at death's door.
This isn't the melody that lingers on, it's the malady that malingers on.
We'll be right back.
I don't care if people criticize my music because I basically just don't care what they think of it. I do it for myself, not for other people. So I don't mind people liking it. I like it if they like it for the right reasons. Obviously, you can't choose your audience. You can't be standing in every record store in the world and, you know, interviewing people when they buy your records. It's good that people buy them because it's a perpetuating thing. That's how I can afford to go back into the studio.
What kind of person would be the ideal Foetus record buyer?
I don't know, a beautiful blonde, I guess.
No.
38, 24, 36.
All right.
You can take the ham out of the man, but not the pig. You can take the will from a man, but not the swill.
P-I-G-S-W-I-L-L. Destroy!
Double Texan. North, south, and west.
I'm coughing up blood in a nice clean shot. Those ideas from rows of blocks. You see the light at the end of the tunnel and roll the dying, the dying llama. One round there, as we recall. Black, 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 all against the wall. Put me out of my misery. I'm dying to get away from it all. North, south, hey, west. My lips are blue.
Feedback from audiences only by hearsay. Usually people are too alienated by my onstage persona to actually approach me afterwards. Some people think it's a rip-off, but I say to them, it's a totally different way of expression. I've made a lot of the musical decisions in the studio. I've, you know, made a lot of those artistic decisions. They're done, they're on tape. That gives me an opportunity to concentrate on putting across what I'm singing on a one-to-one level in a much more illustrative manner. The performances are pretty visual.
Agony.
Was that kind of visual performance typical of how you perform as a Foetus person?
as a foetus person. I guess, yeah, something along those lines, except it's just me on stage. Usually there's fairly copious light show, because when you're one person, you do have to create some sort of visual foil. I mean, I have done totally stripped down performances where it's just been me with no visual counterpart whatsoever, and that's really trying people's values and attention by then. But I mean, I use a lot of pyrotechnics.
I like the short, sharp shocks. Most of the foetus sets that I've done have been not much longer than 30 minutes, mainly because that's as long as I need to make my point, and I'd rather compact everything that I have to say into that time and make one short, intense performance. I find bands boring, you know, watching them for more than half an hour or so. How much time do they need to say those things? I think it was great doing, like, one song. Really whetted people's appetite.
Well, I was really pissed off.
Don't please them, just tease them.
I enjoyed the one, but missed the second and third.
But, you know, I like those short, sharp shocks. Short, sharp, squash shocks. Suspended pig heads. Lots and lots of smoke. Lots of strobes and lots of white lights.
And what do you do?
Blasting into the audience. I rock like a mofo. They call me the crotch monster. I just got a rock, man. It's my main outlet. It's a cathartic experience. I have to do it. I'm incredibly grouchy if I don't. It's a long process, but I need to. It's my wife and it's my life.
I just got a rock, just got a rock, just got a rock, just got a rock. I just got a rock, rock, got a rock, rock, got a rock, rock, rock. I just got a rock, 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 man. I just got a rock, just got a rock, just got a rock. I just got a rock, just got a rock, just got a rock.
Get out of here, sounds anxiety. Give me a pain in the side. I wanna wear my shoulders, the atmosphere's cold, and no one gets out alive for life. You just wear your umbilical cord like a noose. Make believe it's a tie. I got a mouth full of ulcers. I'm digging my grave with my teeth. All this pain is silent beyond belief. My guns bleed for you.
No one gets out of life alive. You just wear your umbilical cord like a noose and make believe it's a tie.
I'm thinking about my life.
I'm very critical of my own work, and I have a very specific vision of what I want to get across, which is the dynamic, the marriage of the music and the lyrics. I mean, the way that they work together, the way that they integrate, or the way that they clash. In my own stuff, I'm a fair stickler for detail. I like that to be a certain longevity of my work in terms of, you know, you can listen to it a lot, and there being a layered richness. Thing I've since learned, not only how to make sounds work together to build a certain fatness to the sound, but also how to achieve those sounds and how to use outboard equipment. And I'm really interested in production, and I've done a few bits for other people. Oil used by them.
A lot of people think that a lot of the sounds that I, my songs are more electronically generated, but actually I don't use as much programming as people seem to think. There's a lot of live percussion. Anything that sounds good when it's struck, metal, springs, bits of cardboard, drum cases, anything that I've made apart on the way to the studio, guitars, sampling, violin, sax, just anything I might lay my hands on, bass.
It sounds very orchestral. It's come in and out in a structured sense that's fairly lacking, but it's sometimes structure.
My stuff is heavily structured, then painstakingly structured. Of course, there are random elements, and as pieces progress, and as I try different mixes, more and more rear ahead, I'm very interested in dynamics, basically, and the recording process for me is a process whereby I build in dynamics and structure mainly around the vocal pattern to a certain extent, but there are an infinite amount of elements. Every song I take is a fresh proposition.
I would use anything. I would use anything that will make a noise.
Bye.
You played Chair on a record I saw once.
Yeah.
How do you go about getting the ideas for getting together the chair kit or whatever? I mean, do you just sort of hit something and make it say, oh, that sounds all right?
No, it's more the other way. I mean, it's more like listening to the song and saying, that really needs a bit of chair in there. The whole intention and sound and structure is something which is ingrained into my brain. I know exactly what it is supposed to be, and by the time that I've translated that to someone else,
which is a very time-consuming experience, I may as well have done it myself anyway.
I have been working with the same engineer for the past 2 or 3 years, and we have got a really good mode of language, you know, in terms of he knows what I'm talking about. It takes a long time sometimes. He's very fast.
It takes a long time sometimes. He's very fast. Always calls the shots.
Foetus always calls the shots. When you're brought in to feature in other people's music, does it bother you that they then have the control to tell you what to do?
No, because they don't. I tell them what to do. I mean, that's the way that I work.
Even if you're just there to play a chair?
Well, I was producing that piece, so... They say Foetus always calls the shots.
Do you have a reputation of being pig-headed?
I have a reputation of being a tyrant in the studio, which has been good as far as I'm concerned. They should think that I'm a tyrant because I've been known to throw people out of their own sessions. That's not really my nature socially, but that's the way that I implement my ideas if they want it.
Suck on this, squarehead! I hear you got a 6-inch guarantee of unilateral security.
Well, me and Stalin, we just signed a mutual non-aggression pact.
I'm gonna put case right into effect.
Prepare yourself for a conflict.
I'll cook you a studio show. God,
I turn up the first I treat it.
For me, propaganda is like the highest form of art. I feel very strongly about that because it is communicating on such an emotional level and making such strong statements in such a graphically simple way. It can make such complex statements.
We'll be right back.
a record sleeve is just there to keep the dust off the record, basically. So I like there to be a thematic element to the work. I mean, I think the sleeves are distinctive as, you know, feet sleeves. Elements of style from Russian constructivism and Chinese communist art and slightly neo-Nazi, but jumbling it together so that it doesn't really mirror any kind of political affiliation, but using it on a graphic level.
Here you got a 6-inch guarantee of unilateral security. Well, me and Stalin, we just signed a mutual non-aggression pact. I'm gonna put case right into effect.
Shmoes like Seek Sputnik moving in on my act, the stuff that I'm doing now is more kind of product orientated. I want to create more classical looking designs in the same way that, say, like a Coca-Cola bottle has a timeless quality to it and an incredible graphic strength and beauty which is instantly recognizable. So the stuff that I'm working on now is more like kind of logos for the sleeves.
Do you have a goal in your life that's different from the direction that the music is taking?
Well, you know, yeah, I'd like to be a lawyer. No, I mean, that's, I mean, I don't, I live fairly much. I mean, I do, that's a really weird question.
Do you have a goal in your life that's different from the direction that the music is taking?
Now, do you want to do this hideous part? Yeah, we've got plenty of tape. You've done a couple of radio interviews before, and so you no doubt know that there comes a time when
you have to do a station ID.
Unfortunately,
that's cool. No, that's cool. I don't mind doing station IDs.
All right. In that case, you know the name of the station, or you may not. JJJ.
Okay.
And you know your name and you know where you're from and all that.
Okay. This is Jim Thirlwell from Scraping Foetus Off the Wheel. You're listening to JJJ, and if you're going to get down and pray.
Has gospel music ever been important to you?
I haven't really heard that much of it. I mean, I hear it in passing. I really like it, just bits and pieces that I hear. But I haven't heard all that much. I mean, it appeals to me. There's a lot of genres of music that I've kind of tried to exploit or tried to do slightly feetified versions of that I don't necessarily know anything about.
Thank you.
I hate country music.
Country and Western?
I hate country and Western. I hate country and Western.
Classical music?
Yeah, I listen to quite a lot of classical.
Classical music.
Yeah, I listen to quite a lot of classical.
What is all the pigdom stuff?
Well, pigdom cum is the fetal expression of heaven. And Nail is a concept LP about the nature of repression, and it's meant as kind of little oases within that, which I wanted to convey using some of the mechanics which allude to a sort of cherubic Disney schmaltz, fluffy cloud vision of heaven.
When you are the mellow parts, the instrumental little pieces, that's part of you. And there are times when it goes absolutely berserk. And there's a track on the blues side that I can't even remember, that's almost difficult to listen to. Private War, isn't it? It could be.
Well, I mean, it doesn't correlate that literally. Not every song on Nail is a reflection of a personal experience anyway. I mean, Enter the Exterminator, for example, is written from the point of view of being in a concentration camp or a South American jail or something along those lines, which I haven't done.
Hear the sweet sound of syringes crushed underfoot.
To the tune of 100,000 volts, man.
I'm gonna explode.
Hey, turn the tables. Turn the tables, for Christ's sakes.
DI-19026 is like a recruitment song sung from Manson's point of view, and, you know, I am not Manson, you know, and I don't purport to be, unlike some people.
I am the son of Slam.
I'm trying to think of the words, and it's got the rain in the background.
Oh, yeah, Sick Man. About Nick Cave, that song.
Of not a lot, skin and bones, rings and crown, legs reach right down to the ground, swivel hips and loose lips, stab the dagger, turn it round. His life's an open book, scribbled in his own blood. His constant companion is always at hand, making entries in his diary, the diary of Sick Man.
Well, the voice wasn't necessarily supposed to be a takeoff of Nick Cave, but maybe unconsciously it was, because the lyrics are about it. As the song progresses, he kills his girlfriend and gets trapped down an alley and killed, riddled with bullets, which is not a fact. That's where a little whimsy took place. Wishful thinking.
Are you a fan of Nick Cave, by any chance?
No, I like him. He's good. Definitely.
We'll be right back.
of the angst-ridden youth? Is do drugs play a big role in the way you perceive or act?
No, I wouldn't say that. Not on the air, anyway. I don't believe in the glorification of drugs, you know. I just think that's pretty boring. Totally boring.
Well, that's the one thing that...
And there's nothing more boring than people who talk about drugs as well. People still level a lot of accusations at me about drug relationships in my work, despite that.
And what do you do in New York to keep you awake at night?
To keep me awake at night? Well, I don't... You know, it's a weird question. To keep me awake at night? I really keep pretty much to myself. I don't leave the house that often. I don't usually go out and party hardy. I mean, I do spend some time in Central Park and so on. I take a lot of the things that New York has to offer for granted.
Like watching squirrels and rats mate in Central Park?
Yeah, those sort of things.
I saw that the other day.
I'd like to see the spawn of that. I'm really trying to get a lot of different input and learn a lot of new approaches before I start even thinking about the next Foetus LP, but I know how it will be in terms of the lyrics and a lot of the subjects that I want to attack. It will be probably as much of a departure from Nail as Nail was from Hole, which is quite radical.
Hole, Nail, and or vice versa, obviously.
Some 12 inches at the moment. I'm starting to write for my next LP. I've written a few songs which will probably be on it, but I'm not even thinking about recording it until next year probably. This year I'm concentrating on quite a lot of collaborative stuff and tying up a lot of loose ends, basically because I want to clear my head from Nail, which for me was the record that I always wanted to make. It was my ultimate statement, and I feel that I could happily die because I've made that record. And I feel that I could happily die because I've made that record.
Bang, it takes two to tangle, it takes one to come. Some things are better left unsaid, like a pound of protection beats an ounce of lead. Bang, there must be some kind of romance in the end. Find a belt full of bullets, fill your head full of dread. Float like a butterfly, sting like a mandarin. It takes two to tangle and one to a one. If you don't suit you, you're better off dead. Cause the pound of protection beats an ounce of lead. There must be some kind of romance at the end. Cause the blind lead the blind, 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 yeah. And every man for himself.
You've been listening to the words and works of the Foetus family, as told to Tim Ritchie by Jim Thirwell, read by Amanda Collins and Neil Sandbach, sampled by Athel Spraggs and cut up by Gary Luther for JJJ.
You start to admire the flame with disregard for the sanctity of other people's lives by the filthy wit, positions of power who go for the jugular in order to survive. Disinfect those dangerous remedies, make sure the kids stay in. Cause if you wanna be immortal, you gotta have something to trade in. The battle-jumping soldier of misfortune, that battle they call life, with the warm soft breeze of sand whispering around their field rivals. I'm a cockroaching yacht in Soul Town. Cry you mercy, I am the law when the time will.
Nothing really gets in the way of my getting things done except myself. There's nothing to get in my way because I'm one person and I do my own stuff, you know. The only thing that gets in my way is my own paranoia, neuroses and mental blocks that I have to battle. I mean, those are the main things, apart from, you know,
schmucky record companies.
How do you deal with that?
Usually with a gun.